The Toronto County Council to ensure the highest possible standards and conduct in their interscholastic programs. We ask that everyone present demonstrate an attitude of good sportsmanship throughout the contest. No matter what personal feelings and loyalty they may have toward one team or the other, obscene cheers, throwing of objects, and verbal indignities directed toward athletes, coaches, or officials have no place in high school athletics. Any spectator not displaying appropriate conduct will be asked to leave the game. Your cooperation is expected and appreciated. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Painter Gymnasium for tonight's varsity basketball contest. At this time, we ask, please rise. Gentlemen, remove your caps. Face the colors of our flag for the playing of our national anthem.
Yeah! Thank you.
His first, team four.
Yeah. Thank you. Marquette fans, don't forget, right after the game tonight, Brooke Rick and her crew will be cooking tenderloins down the ice at Columbus Hall. Stop on down, support the Crusaders Athletics, and have a good tenderloin along with a cold Coca-Cola. At this time, we'd like to introduce the Marquette Lady Knights 7th grade girls basketball team. They finished second place in a state tournament. The head coach, Brian Powers. Assistant coach, Tim Jerky. Manager, Mason Powers. Marquette defeated Wallace to win the Vermillion Grade School Conference Tournament Championship. In the regional, the Lady Knights defeated Woodland in the semifinals and Wallace in the regional final 34-20. In the sectional final, Marquette defeated Mazan Verona Kinsman 39-4. At the state tournament, Marquette continued on the running ways with a quarterfinal victory over Carrollton St. John's 29-12. In the semifinal, Marquette faced off against an undefeated Danville Schlarman team and upset Danville Schlarman 34-31. Marquette ran into Siegel St. Michael's in the final, and our Lady Knights overcame a 11-0 deficit to tie the game late at 22 before St. Michael's pulled away for a 32-24 win. This was the best finish for any junior high girls basketball team in the school's history. Let's give these girls one more round of applause.
Thank you.
PJ Arrington along with Charlie Westerdahl.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.